Okay, great. Let's do a quiz having to do with data consistency. Now, in this case, we're going to look at stock symbols for three different companies over a period of several years. This is an example drawn from the Bad Data Handbook. Spencer Burns, in his chapter, When Data and Reality Don't Match, tells this story having to do with unique identifiers for a few different companies that are publicly traded. So for most of the 20th century, stock symbols for Kmart and Sears were KM and S, respectively. Sprint also, during the time it was a company during the 20th century, had the stock symbol FON, or phone. So now let's take a look at what happened with regard to these unique identifiers for companies as we move forward in time. And what I want you to think about is, what type of challenges might this present to us from a consistency standpoint in thinking about auditing data and cleaning data? So in 2002, Kmart filed for bankruptcy and was then delisted as a stock. In 2003, they recovered from bankruptcy, were relisted, but this time with the stock symbol KMRT. In 2005, Kmart and Sears merged, and so all former shares of Kmart became SHLD, or Sears Holdings, as did Sears stock. And then later that year, Sprint changed its stock symbol from FON to S. So over a period of several years, three different companies were uniquely identified by five different stock symbols. And in fact, two companies were, depending on which point in time you're talking about, uniquely identified by the same stock symbol. Now, when we talk about these being unique identifiers, we should really be using air quotes. It's this kind of problem that we'll often face when we are looking at data collected from different points in time. The identifiers for specific entities have a tendency to change. Now, this type of data is actually fairly difficult to find. So in this quiz, what we're going to do is look at something similar, having to do with when countries joined the Eurozone and what that means for what currency they were using at a given point in time.